This is a Nissan E-NV200 electric van, and there's two parts of this video, which I'll put chapters at the bottom of the screen there as well. So the first part is about the gear selector here, and if your 12 volt battery is flat and you can't start the vehicle and you need to get it recovered onto a truck or towed, or you just need to push the van, you're not going to be able to get it out of park. So there is a shift lock here that you can push to release the gear lever. So the first part of the video is on that. The second part of the video is this little piece of plastic which covers your shift lock here, and how this is the most expensive car part in the world, probably. So if your vehicle has got a flat 12 volt battery up front and you need to get it out of park, what you need is a screwdriver, and then you get it under this little plastic cover here and you ping this up, but do not lose it. So put that somewhere safe, somewhere really, really safe, and then either get a flat key, or in this case a screwdriver, and you can push down there and you'll feel a bit of a spring-loaded something down there. What would I describe that for? Anyway, a little lever you're pushing in there that's got a bit of a spring on it. Push that down. It's a bit difficult to do this one-handed, but anyway, that will then release the gear selector there, and we can move that gear selector down to neutral. And at this point, even though the van's got no power, you can now release the handbrake and you can push the van, or if it's getting recovered up onto a tow truck, they can then winch it onto the tow truck. So the reason why I say do not lose this cap is this is just ridiculously expensive. It's unbelievable. So how much do you think this little bit of plastic is? It is only about 8 millimeters. It's half the size of my thumbnail there. A little blanking plate with a few little prongs on the back, which just slides into that hole there. Well, if you'd have said this was a fiver, you would think, yeah, car parts are expensive. I could believe that. It should be about 20 pence. If you'd have said it was £15, you think, Jesus, that's a lot of money. But that currently, as of June 2023, from Nissan UK, that is £202.43. Yeah, you heard me right, 202 quid for that little bit of plastic there. That's not for the whole surround or the gear shifter knob or anything like that. That is just for that little cover. I'll put the part number for that in the video description below and you can check it out yourself. However, the same part is also on pretty much every Nissan model that has a gearbox, not just electric, but all the combustion engine vehicles as well. So actually you can buy it for a GTR in Japan for about $12 or something. And you can buy them in America for sort of $20. I had a look on eBay, but of course you got to wait for it and possibly pay import duties. But to buy this in the UK for a Nissan E-NV200 is £202. And I queried it with the dealership and they did a query on the price back to Nissan UK to say, look, you know, this is ridiculous. They couldn't believe it themselves. And Nissan came back and said, yes, we got the price right. That is the price. That's what you got to pay. So it's just astonishing, isn't it? So I have done a video about the price of car parts. I'll put a link to it in the top of the screen and in the video description below, because there's a few other things which are just absolutely crazy prices. However, I think this one is the worst I've seen yet. But if you get in a vehicle and this is missing, check around the vehicle, because I've just picked this vehicle up myself today and it was missing. So the first thing I do before I vacuum out the vehicle is I get the torch and I look under all the seats, look in the glove box and all the cubbies to see if this was in here, because I've experienced it before and I knew what these things cost. Because if it gets recovered on a truck or the battery's gone flat or whatever, these will get pinged out and they'll often be left in the vehicle somewhere, or someone might get a screwdriver under it and it'll go ping and it will fly behind the seat. But they'll often be in the vehicle somewhere. But if you don't find it, these are easily sucked up with a vacuum cleaner, so they can soon go missing. So if you get in a vehicle and that's missing, have a really good look everywhere first, because you don't want to be buying a new one of those clips. So anyway, that's going to be going safely back in there, and I'm not going to touch that again in case I lose it. Okie doke, that's it for this video. As always, if you found it useful, please do click the thumbs up button. It really does help. If you want to know more about the Nissan E-NV200 and see other videos I've made on these electric vans, I'll put a link to a playlist in the video description below. Do subscribe if you're not, and I'll see you on the next video.